And it's lights out, and away we go. It's been a good start from Hamilton, good start from Bottas. Into the next corner. Oh, Daniel Ricciardo absolutely coming from nowhere there. Now we are into the pits with Sergio Perez. Also, Ricciardo behind, I believe that is. And we've came out ahead of Perez. And now we seem to be in second place because of this incident right here. Vettel in the inside, and Perez in the inside too. We make contact with Vettel, three wide, and we're close enough to get a good slipstream down the inside. Vettel locks up, and now he is battling with Perez. But now, on lap 23, we're into the pits for our final pit stop, and into the slipstream we go. Surely we'll get past him now onto the straight, and I think we have. Yes, we have, and it's going to be Valtteri Bottas. He comes round the final corner. He will take the Bahrain Grand Prix. Then we round off the podium today for P3. What is up, guys? The Cruise 51 today. We are back with a brand new video, and it is career mode. We're here finally after a month or a couple months off. But you guys have been wondering, where has career mode been? And I'll answer your questions right now, and that is basically since the F1 season is finished, I want to get on with a few recreation videos and stuff to round off the F1 season. Then we get back to career mode and stuff, and that's what we're doing right here. We're into the new year, we're 1 week into 2018, and we're back with career mode. So expect to see career mode more often during this year. Try and get season 1 possibly finished before F1 2018. It sounds a long way, but that's how slow my F1 2017 career mode videos are at the moment. But yeah, we're getting right into it here, guys, in Russia. It is the Russian Grand Prix, so expect qualifying to be really crucial, because obviously we know how the race is going to be. It's going to be really hard to overtake. So as you can see, we did get pole position, and then for the moment, and then Bottas took it off us. But as we went into our final flying lap, as you can see, we were fastest in the first two sectors, which would lead into the final couple corners. It'd be all down to if we could nail our apexes, and could we do it as we cross the line, and it would be pole position in Russia. It's our first pole off the F1 2017 career mode. Unbelievable stuff there. So an unexpected pole. Bottas putting a lap, it was 4 tenths quicker than us, then me pull out a lap, it's almost 3 tenths faster. So unexpected stuff there, but yeah, maybe the upgrades have helped because my engine as well, so that kind of helps. But that's qualifying done now. It's time to see how this race is going to be. Now let's head to the Russian Grand Prix. So, race day, and we see rain. Rain here in Russia for the Grand Prix. It was going to be dry, but it turns out it's going to be wet now. So, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this race now. It's going to be wet, the first wet Russian Grand Prix held. And, yeah, it's going to be really interesting, the championships there, and so is the constructors. You've got to have a look at that. And now, I'm going to head you over to David Croft, who's going to run through the official grid order.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Ferrari in pole position then, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Hamilton, Daniel Ricciardo, and Verstappen, Ocon, Perez, Massa, and Nico Hülkenberg, Kvyat, Stroll, Fernando Alonso, and Sainz, Magnussen, Palmer, Pascal Wehrlein, and Marcus Ericsson. Van Dorn and Roman Grosjean starts from the back of the grid. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Thanks for that, David Croft. And there was your official full grid order for today's Russian Grand Prix. Now, if you notice near the back of the grid, Stoffel Vandoorne and Romain Grosjean have grid penalties. No surprise with Vandoorne and the McLaren, but maybe Grosjean again blocked somebody in qualifying, and that's why he's got a penalty. Because I wouldn't think Haas would be changing components already in the only 4 races of the season, so it must be. I would expect McLaren, yeah, but not Haas. But yeah, as we all line up onto the grid here, there's Valtteri Bottas taking his slot. He'll be looking to try and get the jump on us into the first corner. It's a long way down, and obviously the first wet starts, so we've got to nail it here, because if we don't, we could possibly see 3 wide or 4 wide in the first corner, and that's terrifying, as Lewis Hamilton found out in the real-life Russian Grand Prix last year. Remember the first bit of the track, it was Max, Raikkonen and Hamilton, 3 wide, so close to contact. We could see that in this Grand Prix, but it's wet, so I have to be more cautious now as the lights come on here in Russia to get this first wet race underway. And it's lights out, and away we go. It's been a good start from us, good start from Bottas, and a good start from Vettel as well. three of us got good starts. I think everyone's got good starts, actually, the top four. And now Bottas pulls up to the right. He makes contact with us there. Hamilton's out of nowhere. Three wide into the first corner. I had a feeling this was going to happen. Can we survive the first corner without any contact? Somehow we do. Bottas makes contact with a rear tyre. And now we're on board with Max Verstappen there. There is Sergio Perez, I believe, getting involved. He's trying to go around to outside of Sebastian Vettel. The two Mercedes find out. We lead by a second into the next corner. And there's Sergio Perez spinning out. And oh, there's been a massive shunt in the back there. Oh my God. I believe that's Stoffel van Dorn. And that's a Haas to Grosjean. A Sauber's been collected in that as well. Chaotic start here in the first wet Russian Grand Prix. Oh my God, that's insane, guys. And the virtual safety car was out as well to mention that. So where is everybody now? I'm trying to figure out where everybody's gone. Like, the top three, it was me, Bottas and Vettel. Now it's me, Bottas and Ricciardo, because Hamilton was in the lead at one stage. He took us in the first corner and then he backed out a little bit. But now the green flags are away and we're racing once again here in Russia, coming to the end of lap one. We've got a little bit of advantage, actually, so somehow we managed to survive that first corner, three wide in the wet, and Bottas tried to go round outside of us there. As you see, we went a bit wide, trying to get used to the conditions. We do over a 2 minute lap time there, so that's weird to see. Obviously, a really long circuit as well. So now we lead from Bottas there and Ricciardo behind. So Ricciardo has got a really good start, actually. I believe he started in fifth place. So two positions made up for Ricciardo there. As we now skip later on to lap six of the Grand Prix. Obviously, I was going to mention as well the predictions for this weather is going to be dry later on in the race. So we got to a stage and it was lap six where you can see the conditions are starting to dry up. And now we're trying to look to keep our tyres nice and cool there. We don't want to rub the tyres out really early, trying to go on the dry lines. But now, so skip later on, a couple laps later, Ricciardo got Hamilton at the start. And now Hamilton's looking to get his revenge on Ricciardo. Has he done it? I think he has. Will Ricciardo try and fight him back? No, he doesn't. Hamilton overtakes Ricciardo and takes back P3. Where he was at right at the start of the Grand Prix, so good stuff from him. And just a couple laps later on there, the conditions now have dried up massively. Actually, I believe this is more than a couple laps on, but I believe it's another six laps on. So no action going on at the moment, no surprise, to be honest. But yeah, now Ricciardo into the pits to put on a set of the super soft tyres, try to get the jump, maybe on Hamilton, because he stayed out as well. There's a lot of cars coming into the pits here, so we've stayed out for another lap, and so's Bottas and Hamilton. So they try to react to what we're going to do, see if they can gain time on us, but maybe Hamilton should have boxed that lap as well, when I was thinking. There's Massa into the pits. Set super soft tyres going to his Williams, and now he got held up there from Nico Hülkenberg. Hülkenberg now and set his super softs. I think everyone's going to go into the super softs there. Maybe people might go into the softs to maybe stay a bit fresh with the tyres. The Williams not ready, or the Williams crew not ready for Lance Stroll there, but he gets away with it just by a couple seconds. So many people into the pits here. So yeah, including us actually now, because a lap. Well, just a lap, the same lap to be honest, I was going to say, not a lap later on, but literally, we're literally right at the end of the pit as soon as they're coming out. So yeah, we're into the pits now, and there's Bottas behind us coming in. I believe Hamilton's going to come in too, which is going to be annoying, because maybe Hamilton might need to stack behind him, depends on how close he is. So we're in for our stop there. It's going to be a good stop from the boys, hopefully it is. Yes it is, we're away from Bottas. And what's going on with Bottas here? Has Bottas got a 5 second penalty? I believe he does, and look, that's not going to help Lewis Hamilton. So Bottas away, and there's Hamilton into the pits. He's going to lose a lot of time, and even Vettel, he loses a couple seconds there. There's Hamilton. Hamilton gets out ahead of Vettel somehow, and there's Ricciardo, believe going out. No, that's Verstappen. I keep mixing the two Red Bull drivers up. So Bottas still not losing out. I was surprised in that there, because he had a 5 second penalty. And there was Esteban Ocon into the pits as well, followed by the McLaren of Fernando Alonso as well. The team are not ready for him there. So Van Dorn's obviously just been in the pits just before us there. So there goes McLaren Alonso out the pit. So now, as I was right earlier, Ricciardo has now got the jump on Lewis Hamilton, but Hamilton once again looking to get the revenge on Hamilton looking to get the revenge on Daniel Ricciardo once again in this Grand Prix. Shoots past the Red Bull, and I'm just wondering if he did have some kind of problem, because it just seemed to shoot past him quite massively, or it's just a Mercedes power. And I could be right actually, because as we skip a lap later on, Hamilton's pulled away massively, and that is because Ricciardo, his engine has went. Ricciardo's going to be retiring from this Grand Prix, parks over to the left hand side of the track, and now that is going to cause a safety car here in Russia, which we are going to react to massively with 8 laps to go. You're going to come in and put on a set of the ultra soft tyres and see how our pace is going to be at the end. We could stay out, but basically we're going to just going to come into the pits and see how fast we can go. Let's race to the end, guys. And now as we come in, we get the pit limiter perfectly, I believe, there. And now the team are ready for us. We're in lean mixture to save some fuel, getting ready for the restart soon. Obviously, we'll have a couple laps with the safety car. But now ultra soft tyres go on, and away we go. So we're just going to see where we're going to come out, actually, because there was the Mercedes, I believe. Is that Bottas? Yeah, I think that's Bottas. There, so I wonder where we're going to come out. Can we get ahead of Vettel, actually? This could help. There's Hamilton. There's Vettel. Could be close with Vettel, actually, but no, Vettel's just going to come out ahead. But what, is there anybody else coming down, actually, as we tap the wall there? I don't know what we're doing, but yeah, we come out in fourth position. For the safety car is just about to come in, actually, as well, after a couple laps. So after we've been in, set of ultra soft tyres, we're ready to go. Bottas leads the pack from Hamilton and us. We're going to have to get past our teammate. No team orders here, proper racing. And will Hamilton give Bottas a challenge as well? And you can see we are dying and so desperate to get going here. We're right up the back of Vettel's gearbox, and oh my god, we almost went to the back of him there. Bottas backing them up really massively, forcing everyone to go wide. Everyone's everywhere, the top four, actually. And we've got to watch it for Max Verstappen too. But now I believe Bottas is away. Yes, Bottas is now away. So Bottas leads Hamilton from Vettel and us. So can we get a really good jump on Vettel? We go a bit wide into the last corner, try to get ourselves a good exit. We're right up the back of Vettel now, and surely into the first corner we can get past Sebastian Vettel, because we've got to hunt down the two Mercedes. We have so many laps in this Grand Prix left, and now we've got a really good slipstream. Vettel's going to go defensive because we know it's for the podium. He's not going to give up, and we almost make contact there into the first corner. What a braking from us, but it turns out it wasn't, because look, we went off the track and Vettel's going to fight us back, and Vettel is not giving up here. Oh my god, this could cost us the Grand Prix if this happens any longer. There's Verstappen, we come across Verstappen. Oh my god, what a close call between the Red Bull. Max is up ahead of our teammate Vettel. He's up into fifth. Brilliant racing from Sebastian Vettel there. Oh my god, what a restart. Vettel somehow hang on round the outside, and we were banging tyres. That was amazing racing from Vettel. He did not give up there. And look at Hamilton. Hamilton's not giving up too, because we're trying to hunt him down. Now we're going side by side with him for P2 here. We've got three laps left after this. Bottas is only there. Can we get round the outside of Hamilton to this next corner? We know we've got the grip. And to be honest, if I was to actually be honest here, I can't really feel the dirty air with these new tyres. So maybe Russia is an okay circuit to race, I'll be honest. Depends. And now we go into the next corner. We try to squeeze Hamilton to the outside. Now it's into the inside. Hamilton's got the inside line. But now we cut across Hamilton and we're into P2. Brilliant racing with Lewis Hamilton and the Mercedes again. So what a lot restart that was. And as you can see, that was actually a lap on, because obviously we had to try and hunt down Hamilton again after that battle with Vettel, because it wasn't going to take, we're not that quick to try and catch up with the Mercedes here, because Mercedes have really good pace on these super soft tyres anyway, even though we've got the grip advantage. But now on to lap 26. Here we go then, the battle for the lead. Can we get Valtteri Bottas onto the straight here? He's going to go defensive now, and we're going to get forced to the outside. Into the next corner we go. Bottas will lead. Can we try and go round the outside? No, Bottas holds us off, but we're going to try and get a nice exit out of this next corner. And we're following Bottas really closely here, so when I'm driving, I don't really feel the dirty air at Bottas. So it's really good to see that, considering Russia is a really hard circuit to race it for these cars. And now we're going to try down the inside at the next corner. It's not going to work. We know what we're going to do. We're going to try and get the DRS onto the straight. And look at this. We're basically pushing Bottas out the final corner. And now, as I said, the final corner, we are now onto the final lap of the Russian Grand Prix. It was a wet start and now dry. It's now dry as we come to the final lap. And now, Bottas, here we go. Into the first corner. We pull out to the inside line. Into the first corner we go. Bottas and me are going side by side, and Bottas gives us a tap on the rear there. Oh my god, that was really dirty tricks from Bottas there. I'm being serious, I did not turn into him one bit. Oh, that was really dirty from the AI, I'm not going to lie there, I've never seen that. Me and Bottas into the first corner, went side by side, Bottas held it, and then we just got a much better exit. Bottas decides to turn and gives us a close call, because we had to turn full look to the left and then to the right, because if he didn't hold that perfectly, we would have been in the barriers and out of this Grand Prix, which would have been a real shame. See a last lap battle fade away. But now it's not over yet, because look, as we come onto the straight once again, the main straight, the only chance left of this Grand Prix to actually try and get past Bottas. And now here we go into the slipstream of Bottas. We go, Bottas will push us to the inside of the wall. We're almost banging tyres. We take the lead. Bottas is now fighting us back. He's trying to go around the outside, but we've done it. We've took the lead of the Russian Grand Prix with only 3 corners to go in this Grand. Oh my god, I can't believe it. We've took the lead with only a couple corners to go, and look at that. But Vettel's catching Hamilton as well for the podium. Everybody ended up so close in the end. But now as we come into the final corner, we are going to win the Russian Grand Prix. Absolutely brilliant drive. Oh my god, what a race. But we've got 4th. Okay. Wait a minute. So Bottas has... Wait, oh my god, this makes no sense. Bottas has won the Grand Prix. Did we get a penalty? I really can't remember getting a penalty. Do you guys remember getting a penalty? Because I can't. Because I've showed everything in the video, and I'm pretty sure that reaction right there is just caught... oh my god, right, Ken, why am I happy about that? Bottas wins for Hamilton and Vettel. Okay. Is this a glitch with the game or something? Because I'd really like to know, because we should be doing that right now, not Bottas. I'm pretty shocked by that. Is the game literally just... Oh my god, wait, have we just literally been hanging by Codemasters? So Codemasters just said, no, we just did not win that race. But after a brilliant race, they just took it away from us. And it turns out, I re-watched my replays onto the second pit stop I made coming in for ultra-soft tyres, and look! I was right. I speeded into the pits, and to prove you guys that I even showed you it, we were 3 miles per hour over it. Here's a replay. Like, the safety car's out. Look, we don't even get told what speed we're going into the pits. Just to prove. Look at the side, and we brake, and then we're at 40 miles an hour. We didn't get told. And listen to this. Our engineer does not even come over the radio and tell us. What? Oh my! That's unbelievable. And I had to look at that. Bottas got a penalty too, so Hamilton almost won the race. But I had to look at the race director, and it turns out we did. We got a 5-second stop and go penalty. But obviously that just got put towards us at the end. But they should have just gave us a penalty when we're in the pits. I don't understand that. But because of that, me and Bottas now lead the championship. We tie on the championship, and there we go. Look, it was a stop go penalty as we come to the pits. So a mistake from us there. But yeah, that's just really unlucky. But yeah guys, overall, thank you guys so much for watching this video. The race has been absolutely phenomenal. What a Russian Grand Prix it was. Make sure to leave a like on this video. The support and Karim has been really good recently. Comment below what you thought of that Grand Prix. And also, make sure to rate the race at the top of the cards, right? Midway through the video, we'll have a poll for 10 out of 10 all the way down to 1. What you guys think of the race. But yeah, once again, thank you guys so much for watching this video and showing the support, the support on the Korean War recently. The Spanish Grand Prix will be out very soon, so make sure you look forward to that. And yeah, I will see you guys next time.